Good morning, students. In this video, I would like to speak to 7th standard students. Students, we have been talking about heat and measurement chapter. In the chapter, we have discussed about different sub-concepts related to heat and measurement chapter. Especially in this video, let us talk about clinical thermometer. What are we going to discuss in this video now? Yeah, clinical thermometer. There are some students sitting before me, beside me, and I'm expecting response from you students. Students, what are we going to learn in this video?
About clinical thermometer.
Good. Tell me.
Clinical thermometer.
Very good.
Clinical thermometer.
Very good. Okay. We are going to learn about clinical thermometer. Students, image of the clinical thermometer is displayed on the screen. You can see there. Students, generally when we are suffering from fever, our body temperature increases or decreases?
Increases.
Very good. When we are suffering from fever, our body temperature increases. So, can you find how much body temperature has increased? How can you find?
With clinical thermometer.
Very good. By using clinical thermometer, we can find how much body temperature is increased. Before that, you should know that what is the normal human body temperature, okay? You should know what is normal average human being temperature. You know, okay, of course you know that. But doctors use a thermometer to find what?
Clinical thermometer.
To find out the temperature of bodies, it's called clinical thermometer. Okay, you can see the students, those who are watching this video also, you can see the image of the clinical thermometer displayed on the screen, students. Here you can see here, right? Okay, and what is clinical thermometer? If the question comes like that in your examination, how do you answer? Doctors use a thermometer to find out the temperature of human bodies or any body, any other living body, any other living body. Okay, that's called clinical thermometer, right? Okay, students, now what you have to do, hold the clinical thermometer in your hand and observe carefully. See that thermometer image is displayed on the screen, you can see there. Yeah, see, there are two types of scales marked on the clinical thermometer. Yes or no? Clinical thermometer is marked with two different scales. Students, in the previous class, we have talked about units used to measure the temperature. Can you say the units used to measure the temperature?
Boiling point?
Units, you know, if you are measuring the distance of any particular place, you use meters, centimeters, like that, you know. In the same way, if you are measuring
degree
the
temperature.
Very good. In the same way, if you are measuring the body temperature, the intensity of the temperature, the level of the temperature, that is measured with some units called degree Celsius. It's a scale. Okay, degree Celsius units are present on the clinical thermometer. Along with the degree Celsius scale, other units also present. What are those units called, you know? Degree Fahrenheit. What do we call that?
Degree Fahrenheit.
Degree Fahrenheit. Degree Celsius and degree Fahrenheit. Two different scales are present on the clinical thermometer. Got it, students? Two different scales are present. Okay. Students, you can see the image on the screen, you can see that. There are two types of scales marked on the clinical thermometer. One that starts with 35 degrees Celsius and ends at 45 degrees Celsius. You know, the number you observe that, the clinical thermometer, numbers on the clinical thermometer, if you keenly observe, you can see the number that starts from 35 degrees Celsius, 35. You forget about the unit scale, like degree four, degree Celsius or degree Fahrenheit, you just see the number first of all. Here the number starts from 35 and ends at 45. 35 and 45. Why only this range of numbers are taken on the clinical thermometer, do you know?
Because the normal healthy human body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius.
Okay, and good, good.
And in that temperature, there was 35 to this is average.
Yes, I understood that you got the point. And what about you, Chiran? Why the range of the numbers on the clinical thermometer is taken 35 and 45 in between these these numbers? Why?
A normal human body temperature is 37.
Very good.
If we got high fever, that will go to 45.
That shows in between this range of the numbers, 35 to 45. That's enough, right? That is what, you got the point? Yeah. Students, it's a small logic to understand that you can understand the range of the numbers are taken between 35 to 45 because of this. Human body temperature, normal healthy human body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius, and the range of the numbers, if it's enough to take between 35 to 45, that's enough. Okay, right? Not only 35 to 45, other scale numbers. This is the degree Celsius scale number. Okay, 35 to 45 is the degree Celsius scale number. But what about degree Fahrenheit scale number?
I will tell.
Very good, tell me.
95 degree Fahrenheit to
100 degree Fahrenheit. That's also another range of the numbers that are taken on the clinical thermometer. Okay, that range is enough because that is specifically used to measure the body temperatures, right? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. So the range, the degree Fahrenheit scale is between 95 to 110. That's enough. Okay, students, I think you two got the point, the reason for why the range of the numbers between these two particularly, the two different scales are given on the clinical thermometer like this. Okay, next, on the screen you can see, students, there is another part present in a clinical thermometer that's, first, what is that? Mercury bulb. Next, mercury bulb, a thin capillary line, that capillary tube is extended till the end. Okay, from the bulb throughout the glass stem, you can see there is, in the middle of the glass stem, you can see a capillary tube is extended till the top. Now, after the glass bulb, you can see there is small bend. There is small bend, that bend is called kink or constriction. What do we call that?
Constriction.
Yes, students, you to practice this. The constriction or little bend is there. Okay, why is the kink given? You don't see this kink in other thermometers, right? This kink is given, what's the reason for that? This kink prevents the mercury level from falling on its own. Sometimes as the temperature rises, the level of mercury in the thermometer, it rises, right? Sudden fall down of that mercury in the thermometer, the kink helps to stop falling down itself. Got it? Right, this kink prevents mercury level from falling on its own. That is the reason why the kink is used, right? Next, there is some information given for you, students. You can see here, read the Fahrenheit scale on the thermometer. How to read the Fahrenheit scale on thermometer? Note the temperature difference in between two big marks, markings there on the thermometer, right? big marks and small marks. Bigger marks and smaller marks you can see on the thermometer, right? And note down the number of divisions between these two marks. Note down what? Number of smaller divisions between these two bigger lines or two bigger marks. And suppose two consecutive bigger marks differ by 1 degree and 1 degree Fahrenheit, and there are 5 divisions between them. How many divisions between two consecutive bigger lines or bigger marks? 5. How many?
5.
5 divisions there, you know, and you know, 5 divisions between them. Then one small division reads how much degree? One small division reads
1 by 5 degree
Fahrenheit. One small division, you know, in fractions lesson you have studied, right?
Yeah.
Fractions. Yes, 1 by 5. You know, total divisions are 5 there out of 2 consecutive bigger lines. So that if the gap between these two bigger marks is 1 degree Celsius, and here the smaller marks there, no, the smaller marks that reads 0.2 or 1 by 5 degree Fahrenheit. Students, I think you two got this point, right? This is about the way that how to read the degree Fahrenheit scale on the thermometer. Reading the Fahrenheit scale on the thermometer, that you remember, students. Next point. Do you have any doubt?
How to use a clinical thermometer?
That's what we are going to discuss. Very good. You are thinking about the further topic that what we are going to learn in this video class. Okay. Very good. How to use a clinical thermometer? I think in the previous class we went through some points. How can we use clinical thermometer? A doctor uses a clinical thermometer. I think Shashi, you expressed that, you know, the clinical thermometer is used by putting it in your armpit, and you expressed some points, right? Yeah, that's what we are going to discuss. See, how to use clinical thermometer. The question may be asked you, like a direct question may be asked you like this, you know, how to use clinical thermometer. Students, first thing what you should do, wash the thermometer properly with an antiseptic. With what? With an antiseptic solution. Next, hold it firmly by the end. You have to give some jerks like this. Why to jerk like this? To bring the
level of mercury
in
thermometer
down. Very good. The jerks bring the level of mercury down. That's right, Charan. Very good. Right. And you see that you have to ensure or make sure that the level of the mercury should come down below 35 degrees Celsius or below 95 degree Fahrenheit. I am using two scales here, don't get confused. Okay?
Celsius.
Degree Celsius and degree Fahrenheit. You know, degree 35 degree Celsius is equal to 95 degree Fahrenheit. You just think about it, you just understand like that. Okay? That starts from there only, and make sure that level of mercury in the thermometer should come down to these two scales. Okay? Two numbers on the clinical thermometer, and then now place the thermometer under your tongue. Charan, where to place the thermometer?
Under
tongue or
armpits.
Okay, you have to place the mercury bulb of the thermometer. Next, after 1 minute or 2 minutes, that you know what you have to do, take the thermometer out and note the reading. After 2 minutes, you have to take the thermometer out, and then what you should do?
No.
Should note the reading. You should observe the reading of what reading? The level of the mercury that stands or that remains at a particular point, right? Right? That reading you should.
Sir?
Yes, Charan. What is your doubt?
If there is scale, no?
What scale?
Of Celsius scale, no? If it is stand in two up and down digits, no? In the middle, how can we
note it? Yes, how can we note it? I got your doubt. You know, if the level of mercury stands in between two consecutive bigger lines. In the middle, you know, there are some other further lines, you know, smaller lines. They are also readings, you know, they are also readings of the level of mercury. They can also be, read like, you know, in decimal values in the sense points. In the previous class, I explained about, you know, 1 by 10 is equals 0.1. 1 by 10 is equal to 0.1 degree Celsius. Each smaller mark reads 0.1 degree Celsius. 1 by 10. You know, in between two bigger consecutive marks, there are further 10 smaller marks. Each smaller mark is equals 1 by 10 degree Celsius. That means 0.1 degree Celsius. Got it? 1 by 10 means 0.1 only. Like that. Okay. Here each smaller mark represents that 0.1 degree Celsius. Got? Very good. How to use thermometer? You got the information, I think. Students, I think you two got the information about how to use thermometer. Students, if you are practically doing this and what's your body temperature, can you say that you please record and you just note it like a project work, okay? Not only yours and your brothers and your friends and your classmates, other whoever, elders, you know, like that. You select few people and measure the body temperature and just record, okay? You record the reading of the thermometer, got it? And you do it as a project work. Students, you can see the two images are displayed on the screen. Two clinical thermometers images are displayed on the screen. You please see them. Students, you can also see. See, students, first figure 17, you see here, this is a clinical thermometer, this is also a clinical thermometer. The level of mercury in clinical thermometer, first clinical thermometer and second clinical thermometer, you can, first upper clinical thermometer, you can see there, the level of mercury, where?
8.4.
No. Very good, 98.4 degree Fahrenheit. You should read complete sentence like that. Don't simply give the number. Okay, you should read complete sentence including the units. Degree Fahrenheit or degree Celsius, whatever it is. If it is in degree Celsius, you know, 98 numbers same and the units names are different, then the values will be very different. Got it? So you should read correctly. Right, 98.4 degree Fahrenheit. Students, if you are reading, you should include the units names as well. See here, in first clinical thermometer, 98.4 degree Fahrenheit, and if you take second clinical thermometer, you can see here the level of mercury, you can see here 100, and you can also see the little bit more than 100 degree Fahrenheit. I think 100.1, 100.123, like that. 100.1 or 2 or 3, like that, you know. See here, the level of mercury, you can carefully observe. See here, the level of mercury in second thermometer is more than the level of mercury in first thermometer. See carefully there, and there are some questions for you. And in the picture, first thermometer shows the body temperature of Srika, and in second thermometer it shows the temperature of Srinath. two students' body temperatures. Here, you can say here, for example, who is suffering from fever? Who is suffering from fever now, you can say, students?
Srinath.
Why Srinath is suffering from fever? How do you understand that? How do you decide that Srinath is suffering from fever? How do you decide? Tell me. Very good.
He is above 100.
Shashi, tell me who is suffering from fever here?
Srinath.
Srinath. How do you decide Srinath is suffering from fever?
The level of mercury in thermometer is nearly 100.
Very good. Because normal human body temperature is 98.4 degrees for heat. But the recorded temperature is more than that. That's nearly 100. Next. There is another project work that you need to do here. Here, that I already said, to collect the temperature readings of different persons. You please follow the process that what you have learned, and you measure the temperature of your friends, your classmates, or your known persons. You have to do the project work like this. You have to use the process that what you have learned how to use clinical thermometer, and then you collect the temperature readings of different persons. Okay, students, you too. I will display a table on the screen, students. You can see there. See, first name of the student, estimate the temperature first of all, and use thermometer then. And you just compare the estimated temperature and recorded temperature. So in such a way, if you do, then that project work will be finished. Students, can you say that whether the estimated temperature and measured temperature same?
No.
No. There will be difference, you know.
Sometimes.
Maybe same, may not be same. We cannot exactly decide it. Okay, maybe same, may not be same, right? Next, is the body temperature of every person 37 degrees Celsius or 98.4 degree Fahrenheit? No, every person, so that's not for sure. Here, what you have to do is, you have to add all people body temperature. Okay, add means you have to make total and then divide it with the total number of persons, then that will be the average temperature. Okay, that will be the average temperature of the persons that whose temperature you measured. Next, in the same way, the average body temperature of large number of healthy persons is known as normal temperature. What is normal temperature? Of course, how do you decide only 37 degrees Celsius is normal human body temperature? Because the average body temperature of large number of healthy persons. Okay, the average temperature, average, how to do average, you know? The total of the temperature value by the total number of the persons. Yeah, here the average body temperature of a large number of healthy persons is known as normal temperature, normal body temperature. Students, one thing, do you know that what is the thermometer used to measure the temperature of infants? Do you know?
I don't know, sir.
Do you know? Don't you know? Okay, let me tell you that what is the thermometer used to measure the temperature of infants? Infants are the 0 year babies, below 1 year babies. That thermometer is called thermistor thermometer. You can see the image of thermistor thermometer on the screen, students. See there? That's what. Okay. It's available in market to measure the human body temperature, particularly for infants and children. Okay?
Sir. What is infant?
Infants mean they are the 0 year babies, you know, below 1 year babies. Okay? Right, very good. Ask your daughter like that. Let us see that what are the digital thermometers now. Students, an image is displayed on the screen. You can see that. That's a digital thermometer. So here, digital thermometer is with some screen and numbers are displaying on the screen. Okay, you can see the image of the thermometer. You can see on the screen, students. This is the digital thermometer.
Sir, how can we dispose mercury?
Yeah, disposing mercury is little difficult. You know, that is what there is some concern. You know, students, there is a lot of concern over the use of mercury in thermometer. That mercury is a toxic substance. You know, the concern, you know, people are thinking like that. It's a toxic substance and it's very difficult to dispose if a thermometer breaks. If a thermometer, you know, if the glass thermometer, you know, the glass stem, if it is broken, the mercury comes out of the glass, you know, and it's difficult to dispose. Keeping all of these points in mind, the scientists invented a new type of thermometer, that is a digital thermometer. Got it? So these days digital thermometers are also available. We, you know, don't use mercury as it is a chemical substance. If a glass of a mercury, you know, glass of mercury thermometer is broken, mercury comes out, and if you touch it, it may enter into our mouth or it may enter into our body, and there we may get different diseases. Oh, maybe, right? So we have to protect our body, protect ourselves like this, using digital thermometer.
Sir, I have one doubt.
Very good, ask me. Yes, who invented first thermometer, you asked, right? Very good. The first thermometer was invented by Galileo
in 1593.
Yes.
Just before 1593, how people used to measure the body temperature?
Yes, very good. Before 1593, the people used to measure the body temperature of other person just by touching. They used to feel body temperature. Students, I will show an image on the screen. You can see there, students, you too see there. Students, you can also see here. I will ask some questions. What is the boy doing?
Boy is measuring temperature of fire.
Very good. Boy is trying to measure the temperature of fire. See, what happened then? The thermometer got
broken.
So you should not try like this. Got it? You know why? That it's made up of glass. It's very compressed. Air is not present inside it. Okay? When it is exposed to very hot temperatures like fire, that ultimately gets broken. Got it? Like that. The temperature of objects is measured with other thermometer, but clinical thermometer is not used to measure the temperature of the objects. Okay? And what we are advised here, not to use clinical thermometer for any other materials. We are advised not to put this clinical thermometer in hot sun or near a flame. We should not keep the clinical thermometer close to a flame, or else you should not keep it in hot sun, or else you should not measure the temperature of any other materials. There is another device used to measure the temperature of materials that we will study here. Now you can do, and you just compare the values recorded by clinical thermometer, which is with mercury clinical thermometer and digital thermometer. You just record the temperature values using after measuring using the clinical thermometer, which is with mercury, and which is with, you know, digital thermometer.
Sir, I have one doubt.
Hmm.
The normal thermometer, when we put it near fire, it will get broken. But when we put digital thermometer, what will digital thermometer do?
Digital thermometer will, it's, it digital means it's an electronic device. It is with some sensors inside it, that will also go damaged. Okay, so you should not, it's avoid doing like that. Okay, that is also very sensitive. If you want to put the thermometer in the fire,
if the flame will go high now, some high, and the heat will also spread.
No, you should not keep clinical thermometer there.
I'm asking about digital thermometer.
Digital thermometer, it is also used to measure body temperature only, no? Digital thermometer is nothing but it is a clinical thermometer only.
It is also like
clinical thermometer without mercury.
Okay.
There is a screen on the thermometer. Number will display on the screen while you are measuring the temperature, like that.
Sir, I have wondered.
Yes.
When we go to space. Space with thermometer and went nearby sun and we kept a thermometer nearby sun, the thermometer will blast. It will get damage.
Blast? Otherwise, damage means that only. No, blasting or damaging, it's same.
If we go to space with thermometer, we will be far away from sun. No. If we put in the air,
Temperature, if you want to measure the temperature in the space, that's vacuum, far away from the sun. Children, if you have any doubts, you please note your doubts and we will, specially we sit for clarification of doubts. Okay? Now, how to measure the temperature of materials? How to measure the temperature of materials, other objects? Do you know? What are the thermometers called used to measure the temperature of objects?
Laboratory thermometer.
Very good. Laboratory thermometer. That's nice. Very good. You are listening very well. And here you can see there the image of the laboratory thermometer displayed on the screen. You can see there it's, you know, laboratory thermometer. Observe the thermometer there. You can see there. And as you already studied about the clinical thermometer, which is mercury clinical thermometer, you understood some parts, you know, the construction of thermometer, right? You just label the parts of this laboratory thermometer as well. Minus degree Celsius means less than zero or greater than zero?
Less than zero.
Less than zero. That's enough for you. Next. And how to use? How to use laboratory thermometer? That is the question. See, now what you have to do, take some tap water in a beaker first and dip the thermometer in the water, that so that the bulb is immersed in water, so that the bulb of the laboratory thermometer should be immersed in the water but does not touch the bottom. You see that it should not touch the bottom of the
beaker.
Very good. Okay.
Sir, what is immersed?
Immerse in the sense to dip inside the water, to dip in water, into water. You have to wait till the mercury level becomes steady. Note that reading, you know, that is the temperature of the water. This is how you can conclude the chapter. We have talked about the summary of the lesson. You can see that there are different the lesson started with what is temperature and heat is a form of energy, conversion of energy, different types of thermometers, and expansion of liquids due to heat, and what else? What students, can you help me to say the points of what we have discussed?
About clinical thermometer.
Very good. We have talked about clinical thermometer.
And six magnum
6 maximum minimum thermometer. Very good.
Digital thermometer.
Digital thermometer.
And in fan.
In thermistor thermometer.
Thermistor thermometer.
And properties of alcohol and
mercury.
Mercury. Very good.
And
how to use a thermometer.
How to use thermometer. Very good.
How to use laboratory thermometer.
How to use laboratory thermometer. Very good.
And
yes.
Do not use clinical thermometer to measure materials
temperature. Very good. Very good.
Not put into the fire.
Very good. We should not put the clinical thermometer
and
in the fire.
And who invented thermometer?
Who invented thermometer? So very good. You have learnt a lot from this chapter. I am very happy. And the students, those who are watching this video also, learnt a lot of information from this virtual video class of this chapter. Students, I want you to read the interior learning section of the chapter. You will find the questions. You try to answer for those questions after watching complete videos. Okay, students, this is for this video and this is for this chapter. Students, I am just winding off this chapter, and tomorrow we will continue with next chapter. Okay, I'm expecting every one of you to write the notes and present it in our WhatsApp group, students. And one thing that I want you to understand, that SCA 1 exams are very soon. I'm giving you the portion for 5 chapters. You please be prepared well, and I wish you all the best. Thank you, students. Thank you for listening, and thank you one and all.